Every death that occurs from an asbestos exposure could be prevented.
Don't be fooled. There is a connection.
Everything just ties together.
I don't know what I can do.
It's hard to describe what ADAO has been in my life. I certainly can't imagine it without ADAO.
We've come a long way, and I'm really proud of ADAO.
Keep me in your heart for a while.
ADAO, when you're a volunteer-powered organization, we are all about gratitude. So one is, we really want to thank the Shine Law Firm for hosting that Continental Breakfast this morning. So shout out. We'll do applause. Yeah, we'll applause now. I'm going to go through an opening session here with you very briefly to kind of tell you a little bit about the genesis of the conference, answer some questions, and get you all geared up for the day. We'll be introducing and thanking a lot of people to save some time. We'll save applause at the very end. So for those of you who I haven't personally met, thank you for coming. And to my old friend sitting here, it's great to see you again. I am Linda Reinstein, the co-founder of the Asbestos Disease Awareness Organization, and Doug Larkin and I founded ADAO back in 2004. So on behalf of all of the volunteers of ADAO, we really want to thank our group of sponsors, presenters, honorees, and volunteers for making today happen. You see this line that we use all the time, together change is possible. That is sort of a tagline that we use for ADAO because we really believe in unity and spirit. And I see Celeste nodding. I mean, we've really partnered with some of the strongest allies, not only in the United States, but around the world, to make asbestos exposure a thing of the past. And I think the list of countries participating today is particularly impressive. Now, with regrets, I will tell you, after this is our seventh conference that Doug and I have done, and we've never had, sadly, more personal events that have taken our speakers away. So with regrets, Dr. Michael Harbutt, Dr. Stephen Levin, Sugio Fuyora, and Fernanda Giannassi will not be here today, and not because they don't want to be there, and Beth knows all too well Fernanda was in tears. They've either had health emergencies, family emergencies, or Sugio lives in Japan, and I think you'll all join me in just a quiet remembrance of what is happening in Japan. For those of us who are surrounded by asbestos and advocacy, when we see natural disasters happen, we're not even thinking, our world we're thinking, yes, but in Japan they're trying to get food, water, shelter, medicine. Asbestos hasn't even been reckoned with yet. So Sugio's there for his family where he needs to be. This slide is a kind of a fun one. I don't know if you can really see what's going on there, but in 2005 we held our first press conference in D.C. Doug and I really weren't really sure. It was April 1st, April Fool's Day. What did we know? We picked the day for a reason. We wanted people to know asbestos was no laughing matter and that it killed. You'll see Marilyn Amento, her children, my late husband, Emily, and some others, Dr. Castleman, Dr. Lemon. You know, it's kind of a nice, Les Scramstead, Gayla Benefield. That was the group of usual suspects. We've come a long way. And I'm really proud of ADAO. Doug Larkin and I had no idea when we founded ADAO in 2004 that in 2011 we'd be standing here 6,000 strong, set to go, partnering with the best and the brightest, and that's because of all of you here today. It comes with partnerships, and without that being said, Carmanos has been a fabulous team. They helped draft a great story, which you'll find in your program, about Julie Gunlock, who you'll hear more from later on, but Liz Katz did a beautiful story about Julie. Let's face it, these conferences are expensive, and we want to thank the people that make this possible. Our platinum sponsors really step up to the plate, and the Shine Law Center is terrific, and the Simmons Law Firm are fabulous. And without our platinum sponsors, we'd be unable to videotape and scholarship people. And we want to really give them well-deserved recognition. But along with Simmons and the Shine Law Center, we also have gold sponsors, as in Barron and Budd, and Motley Rice again for another year, and the AdFaro Group. And not to downplay any of the other silver or bronze, but you can see this list and the AdFaro Group. I think it's very important as we look at this list that we want to be very clear with ADAO. We do not make medical or legal referrals. We do not make medical or legal referrals. We have built our relationship in Congress because of our credibility and our independence, and they will never, ever be compromised. During the day, we like to recognize those who have been very generous in their donations, and this is an event host list which you can see quite clearly who has given to us. speakers. Dr. Frank's going to go into this a little bit more, but it's quite impressive. More than 20 people have given time to not only come here, but draft their PowerPoints and their speeches, all in hopes for raising awareness and making this a thing of the past. The honorees today, there'll be 7 awards given out. And again, this has been a long history of ADAO. And you can see that there are tribute of hope, tribute of unity, inspiration, Alan Reinstein Award, as well as Keep Me Your Heart, and of course the Selikoff Award. We are so honored, and I think that Celeste is smiling, and Dr. Miller there. Dr. Linda Ray Murray is a force to be reckoned with. She's amazing. She happens to be the president, not happens to be, she is the president of the American Public Health Association, the one of the oldest public health associations in the United States. 137 years, they have been committed to public health. I don't know about you, but that speaks strongly to me, because it is about protecting public health that will make all of these diseases go away. Jordan Zevon last night and Jordan Summers gave us a little bit of music and levity. He's our national spokesperson and will keynote on Sunday along with Kim and Kristen, who will be presenting. We're really excited about this, and I apologize, I don't have a book in my hand, it's at the counter. Kim and Kristen, we collaborated to come up with a cookbook, and it's not corny, it's really sincere. Cooking is love, and this is all about keeping families together. So for those of you who have ever had someone be ill in your family, or sadly someone who's lost a loved one, your table shrinks. Your cooking style changes. But we found that keeping families together gives us the strength to continue on. I see Hannah nodding in the back. I mean, we know in the Reinstein family, we always made it work, even with a card table in our bedroom during the end of Alan's life. And we always took the levity and love upstairs. So I think that when it comes to food, it's more than something on a plate. It's really something from our heart. So for those attending the Sunday brunch, we're pleased to be passing out this new cookbook as our gift. For those of you who may not be coming, you can purchase it outside for $15. And we're delighted. And again, thanks, special thanks to Kristen and Kim for that. It's important to thank who makes this happen, and we are so powered by our volunteers. You can look at this list, and I'd like for our volunteers to please stand. Doug Larkin gives so much to ADAO. Please stand, Doug. Susan Dupree, Herman Hamilton isn't here. We'll speak to him about that later. Yes. It was through meeting Doug Larkin in D.C. back in 2004 when my husband and Bill Shills were battling mesothelioma that we actually co-founded ADAO based on that first meeting. Marilyn Mento is here today, Jordan Zevon, my daughter, Emily Reinstein, Sherry Erzinger, Sue Ann Taylor. I mean, that's just to name a few. Now, there are some volunteers, obviously, that aren't here. The most important to me personally at this moment in time is Herman Hamilton. This man, through Dr. Castleman's introduction, has worked since 2005 every day. He is so loyal. He doesn't have any of his family members that have been affected by asbestos. His heart tells him to volunteer for ADAO. And Herman's unable to be here, but I hope at the end you'll give a special applause to Herman. So they'll be watching this videotape at a later date. But you can read about Herman in the program. And also Debbie Grano is not here, as well as Josh. Josh Z works very hard, and that's Paul and Michelle's son. Senate resolution, shout out to the Card Clinic. We have been working with members of Congress now for 7 years. This may look like a nothing document, which is in your program. What's important to ADAO is these are all facts now in the congressional record. Dr. Miller shaking his head. These are the facts that we can go back to, that we can power Congress to work towards a ban. As a result of our resolution in our fifth resolution, the Surgeon General actually took heed at the bottom, point three, to issue a so-called warning about the facts about asbestos. We're looking for a stronger warning this year, but it's not just paper, it is action. We are so excited. If you take a look around, this is asbestos in 12 different languages. This marks a momentous opportunity for all of us. Globally, we came together when one of our friends on Facebook who's battling mesothelioma, her name is Mavis, and I know that Anne will be able to take this back through Facebook. Mavis is about 65 years old. She didn't work in the asbestos industry. But sadly enough, she is sick and she has a reoccurrence. She will lose her life to a preventable disease. She will lose her life to a preventable disease. Something's wrong. So as a result of Mavis' plea, can we do something like that in the UK? I knew that passing resolutions and policy initiatives, although we work with the World Health Organization, it takes a long time to get through the channels. So we reached out to the World Health Organization last year. No reply is a reply in my book of definitions. So I took the liberty, and those of you who know me, I use that, took the liberty of deeming this Global Asbestos Awareness Week, and our partners around the world in Australia are printing this, putting it in newspapers, in the UK, all around South America. So be proud today. Many people, Susan I know is shaking her head, we've changed our Facebook pictures, and we have really partnered for prevention. So I think that's quite impressive. So if you want to do any tweeting, Heather, we're use the hashtag of ADAO, and Doug Larkin can certainly answer those questions. So without further ado, we're going to show one quick video. As a result of Asbestos Awareness Week, we have a 60-second quick video. It's just being released today. It'll be on YouTube. You folks can totally share it and push it out. It's done by USC master students, and it's a very different style for ADAO. So I hope you can, I'm not going to say enjoy. It's hard to watch. After the video, Dr. Lemon and Dr. Frank and Elizabeth Cass will introduce you. Okay, cue up the video, please. Thank you.
Thank you all for coming to beautiful, warm Atlanta. I know you disagree with that as of yesterday, but we do have a present for you today. It's supposed to get up to 78. Tomorrow's supposed to get up to 80. And so hopefully the weather will be much better than it has been the last week. This is a little unusual for us in the spring. But for those of you that have allergies, welcome to the allergy capital of the world. And if you go out and you see this green stuff all over your cars, don't worry. It's not anything falling apart. It's just the trees telling us that they're ready to come out for spring. So with that, I'd like to give you a little bit of an overview of our conference today. We're going to have four sessions, and these sessions will be arranged to talk about this nasty substance of asbestos and what we can do as an organization to bring about change. That's what we're all about. We hope we can change the way the world looks at this preventable disease. And as Linda said in her opening, this is clearly a preventable disease. Every death that occurs from an asbestos exposure could be prevented if the world would take notice and ban the use of asbestos. Also, I think most important to us in this room today in the United States, at least those of us that are citizens of the United States, is why has not the United States taken this action? We'll talk more about this as we go on. But our first panel is going to talk about the asbestos impact on public health. And the second, we'll talk about asbestos impact on the economy. Both very important subjects. You can't really talk about public health without talking about the cost that it's going to affect the economy. And as you know, the economy is having some problems right now. We're also going to talk about the effects on the environment. And finally, we hope to be able to wrap up today's session with some action points and talk about what we can do, as I said earlier, as an organization to be positive about this and not just be a complaining organization. We want to actually put out action items that we can follow through with over the next year. And when we come back next year, hopefully we can have some accomplishments from those items. So with that, I'd like to turn the program over to my co-science advisor sponsor, Dr. Arthur Frank.
Thank you, Dick, and good morning to all of you. Having come to these meetings for a number of years, there are a lot of friends who I've made here over the years, and for those of you that I'm meeting for the first time, I'm delighted to do that. My relationship with this group goes back to pretty much its founding, when Linda pigeonholed me as we were standing at a meeting in...
gently recruited.
Gently recruited. You know, in Linda's gentle way, in Tokyo in 2004. And I was delighted and honored to be asked. I've had the good fortune with my good friend and longtime colleague, Dr. Lemon, to co-chair the Scientific Advisory Board. We have what I think is an outstanding scientific advisory board that gives advice about science. And as you heard from Linda, we do not make either medical or legal referrals. And yet, many of us have been involved with the medical legal aspects of this work. And I'm delighted with all of the sponsors that are here, many of them from firms that I have had some interactions with over the years. And know them to care about both their clients and about organizations like this. This meeting is really rather special. It pulls together not only science, but public policy. It pulls from the community of victims of those who have suffered disease from exposure to asbestos, as you heard and as you'll continue to hear over and over, a totally preventable problem, so that we are working very hard to bring about change. I'll have an opportunity to make some additional remarks this afternoon and bring you up to date on some things. Literally had an email this morning that I'll sort of tease you with and keep some information for this afternoon. But again, to thank all of you for coming, thanking our sponsors. It's the size of a group between the breaks and the time over meals and award time that we'll be able to visit with each other. And even on a personal note, you know, Ron Cyrus, who's being honored today, I spent 11 years at the University of Kentucky and was fairly active in health and welfare of workers when I was there, so I actually knew the gentleman, and it's just outstanding that he's getting the award today, and be delighted to meet with some of the family. So with no further ado, let me ask Liz to come up and share some thoughts with you as well.
Right now.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Elizabeth Katz, and I am here on behalf of the Barbara Ann Cardenas Cancer Institute in Detroit, as well as Dr. Michael Harbit, who is our cancer, environmental cancer expert. I know that he certainly would like to be here. He does send his regrets, but I certainly have the honor to speak on his behalf. And we're also very honored to continue our sponsorship of the ADAO annual conference. It's certainly an organization whose message we completely believe in. And so we're very glad to be here. And we have certainly had the pleasure of helping promote the message of ADAO through our own news releases and through social media, through Facebook and Twitter, associated with the Barbara Ann Cardenas Cancer Institute. For those of you who are not familiar with Cardenas, we are one of only 40 NCI-designated cancer centers in the United States and the only hospital in Michigan solely devoted to treating cancer. As part of that institute, we have established the National Center for Vermiculite and Asbestos-Related Cancer, of which Dr. Harbit is a co-director of that. He is also an internationally known expert in the diagnosis and treatment of environmental and workplace diseases. He is co-author of the world's largest study of respiratory health in asbestos-exposed iron workers, and a study that announced the discovery of a blood test for early detection of mesothelioma. He certainly would like to be here, as I mentioned, but he did have a pre-recorded presentation that you will see later on in the conference. But again, we are very proud to sponsor this annual conference and are gratified that we have the opportunity to get the word out about the health risks associated with asbestos exposure. Thank you. Enjoy the conference.
But thanks for coming, and thanks for making this the most successful conference thus far.
Keep me in your heart.